According to Haji Issa Bogere, the chairman of the Association of Ugandans Living in Rwanda, many Ugandans face challenges such as getting work permits, lack of access to loans, and heavy fines. Bogere says they are happy about the restored relationship between Uganda and Rwanda.
I wish to register our genuine thanks to our host country, the Republic of Rwanda, and the leadership of His Excellency Paul Kagame for the continuous support to our community, in which acquaintances, business associates, and friends have become a family to us.
Dr. Andrew Seguya, a conservationist working with tourists in the countries of Uganda, Rwanda, and the DR Congo, says Uganda needs to invest more in the tourist districts because they fetch a lot of money for the country.
We would like to ask the government of Uganda to help us integrate the DR Congo within the East African visa. Many of our people, especially in the tourism sector, have to pay $100 every time they cross into Congo, and sometimes more charges because Congo is a little bit unstructured.
Relations between Uganda and Rwanda could not have been better in the recent past. We are now on a cascading slope. We are going upwards in terms of our relationship. And one of our major focus here at this office is to ensure that these relations stay good and even improve.
The government is pursuing to realize socio-economic transformation. And in doing this, the number of strategic interventions we have planned as government. And one of them is strengthening the peace and security.
The Prime Minister assured Ugandans living in Rwanda that the government has created an enabling environment for investment and promised to address the issues raised.
We are also, as government, facilitating investment projects which have a high return and can reduce the cost of doing business. For example, the standard gauge railway, the construction of more roads, the construction of dams like Karuma. The other day I was visiting Karuma, which is going to give us 600 megawatts.
Earlier in the day, Prime Minister Nabanja visited the Kigali Genocide Memorial Site, where she called for harmonious coexistence of all mankind. Report by Ismail Kasoha for the news.